Welcome back to another episode of Charlie in the 808, where we are going to talk about what the difference is between an ESA and a service animal. So Charlie is an ESA as well as a psychiatric service dog. ESA stands for Emotional Support Animal. According to ADATA.org, an ESA means that they provide companionship, they relieve loneliness, but they do not have special training to perform tasks for people with disabilities. It also defines a service animal as any dog that is trained to perform tasks for people with disabilities, including physical, sensory, psychiatric, intellectual, or other mental disabilities. Service animals are protected under Title II and III of the ADA. My psychologist wrote a letter stating that I need accommodation to have Charlie live with me because of a medical disability that is affecting my quality of life and daily functioning. A big misconception of service animals is that they need to be professionally trained. That's not correct though. According to the ADA, there are no requirements for animals to be certified or registered as service animals. And many training programs are expensive. I believe the average is about $17,000, so the animal's handler can provide the training. So something super important to take away is, according to the ADA, a person can only legally be asked two questions when they enter a public facility. One, is the animal required because of a disability? And two, what tasks is the animal trained to perform? They cannot ask for documentation or proof and are not allowed to ask for a demonstration of the task. With that being said, it is a crime to misrepresent a pet as a service animal, and you can be fined up to $1,000 and or face jail time. So how does Charlie know when to be a normal dog versus when to be when to work, essentially, in the public? Use this vest, and I got this vest from Amazon. It has Velcros over here. Charlie knows that if I put this vest on, it means we're gonna go to public places, and I need to make sure sometimes I put the Velcro signs on him so people don't really come up to him because he really needs to concentrate. So this is kind of his uniform. When I put this on him, to him, he knows that he is a working dog right now. And I'm gonna take it off because I don't want to confuse him. But we use a regular collar and a regular leash whenever we just go on walks. We do just like normal things. But when I need to take him to places, for example, the malls, stores, restaurants, business offices, then I would put this on. And he's actually really good at knowing, like, okay, this vest means I need to behave differently versus without it, he's just, you know, silly monster. So that's one of the differences that you can do for your dog, kind of differentiate between normal behavior versus when they're at work. So some things that I'm trying to teach Charlie is, I'm anxious in public. I am trying to teach him ways to basically help me cope. Having him grab my medications when I'm in public and when I'm having a panic attack. He knows if I say the A word, A-N-X-I-O-U-S, he will react to that and he will come to me and he will apply pressure in places where it will calm me down. So, it's an example of a psychiatric service dog. It's a lot of research to truly understand what the difference is. I want to point out something really important is it really depends on where you live, what state you live, what country, obviously. But depending on the state, there's different regulations and laws regarding ESAs, please make sure you double check on your state's laws regarding ESAs, because I've seen advertisements on YouTube where they say, you know, you can take your pet anywhere if it's an ESA, to restaurants and, you know, etc. But I just want to establish that that is not 100% the case. In Hawaii, some establishments say service dogs only. You cannot bring your ESA, you cannot bring any other type of comfort animal with you. And I think recently you used to be able to bring pets or ESAs onto airplanes, but not anymore, unfortunately. So it really truly depends on where you live. So I would highly recommend to review your state laws. What you doing, silly? If you have any further questions, you can jot it down in the comments below. I Google everything because I'm a nurse, I'm not a professional dog trainer, dog expert. It's very confusing, let me tell you, especially if you're not familiar with the terminology.
I love you so much.
Thank you so much for watching, as always, and please like, comment, subscribe. Please comment on what type of video you guys want next. Till next time,
giggle.